The Formula Helmet, obviously, we launched a few years ago, and this was the natural evolution. And really, when we look back, it was always the plan. We didn't necessarily know how we were going to accomplish the plan, but we knew we wanted to continue to evolve this helmet, have real impact detection in this helmet, because that's been something that's been, I think, needed in our industry for a long time. Because the question I get asked personally a lot is, I crashed, my son crashed, my family member crashed, and we don't know if this helmet is compromised or safe to still wear. So we wanted to try to not necessarily answer that question, but give data that could support an answer to that question. And that's really where the Formula S helmet came in. It's supported by the Fly Smart app that's on any smartphone. You can download it, Android, iPhone, whatever. But it's going to give you all sorts of information, ride analytics, crash impact detection. It's going to tell you if you crashed. In the event of a crash, it will contact your emergency services and your emergency contacts. And there's a paid service that goes along with the higher end upgrades as well. But there's really nothing out there like this, right? It's fully integrated into the helmet. As you can see, if I raise to wake the helmet here, just on the S app there, raise to wake it, it'll start blinking blue there. And that's basically telling you that the helmet is awake, and that's starting to record data. So on your smartphone, you would be able to read what you did on the ride, hard braking, hard deceleration, max speed, elevation, all those things. And if you did happen to crash, it would also record that crash and tell you exactly how hard and how many G's were absorbed by the helmet. Not necessarily your head, but by the helmet.
So in hearing about the presentation that was here and who you guys have developed with this with Quin, really cool. It's not something that you guys are just trying to take on your own. You guys know you're not a technology company. Find a really good one that pretty much made the company because of a motorcycle accident. So how has it been to work with them, and where are they also active?
Well, they're incredible, right? And they had so many pieces of the puzzle. And when I say we wanted to evolve the helmet, we knew we're not equipped for that. We're not developing that technology. So for the Formula and Quin, it was the perfect marriage. They understood our placement as fly racing in the off-road space, and that we could immediately put this into action and it would be well received by consumers. And for us, we understood that Quin are the foremost experts in this space, and we wanted to go right to the best, right? And that everything around the Formula helmet has always been premium, the best of the best, and I truly feel it has the best fit. It's the lightest helmet in the U.S. market. Like, there's so many things about the Formula that are cream of the crop, and we felt Quin was the perfect addition to the Formula to take it to that next level.
So you mentioned that in the tooling of the original Formula helmet, this was always there. It's just taken some time to get there. But as AMA standards have changed, you know, you can't mount anything to your helmet. ECE standards have changed now too. Almost perfect timing, because this thing just seamlessly integrates in the back and it can't even tell.
Right. And that was one of the questions I was getting on our original Formula helmet was, why is it not 2206? And I had to be very careful, because I'm like, in the back of my mind, I'm going, just wait. Like, the Formula S is coming and it's 2206. But you don't want to, you know, give away too much too early. So you kind of get beat up on message boards at times about, oh, it's not even 2206. And I'm like, all right, just be patient, wait for it. So yes, this was always the plan. There was always in the original tooling a place for a sensor and for the gyroscopic elements of this helmet, and now we get to implement all those things. So all the things we're waiting for, all the reasons I had to be patient, I don't have to be patient anymore.
I want to say it was 10 years ago. I remember being at a race and somebody on the TLD team had a telemetry device on them that they were managing, and it went into an earpiece because that's where everything goes.
Mm-hmm.
It was a pretty big little box. Like, for what it was and the data that it was collecting, unbelievably small.
Right.
To see what you guys have sized this thing down to and all the data that's going to feed into it, it's unbelievable.
Yeah, and I have to give Quin a lot of credit for that, right? We developed this Formula helmet with the help of REHON, right? And there were, that whole AIS system was its own project, right? And this is taking all of that, all the great improvements we made and all the revolutionary tech absorption and having rotational linear impact in one material, right? All those things are still intact. That's what made the Formula helmet so great. This is just bringing Quin into the equation and really just taking another elevator ride up. So it's amazing that we didn't have to compromise anything we were already doing. It really just, like, it was the Formula was on this launch pad and it was such a great product, and now it was time to just take off with this thing. And you're integrating all this technology. You think about the app and how complex that is. And once you start, you see this helmet, you download the app, you start to work through everything that's there. There are 100 different screens screens in this app worth of information. So it's endless data that you're going to be recording, and how you want to use that or manipulate it, that's up to you. But yeah, really, sky's the limit there.
It's going to be cool to see over the next few months everything that really unleashes the potential of this, because it's just going to be running updates. It's going to be awesome. So not to get too into the weeds on that, because there's plenty more information to come from. Yep. But really, to summarize this on a quick video, Fly's been around forever. You guys really did. I mean, I remember the first Fly helmet that I had years ago. You guys have become a major presence in this now. And how does it feel to integrate new technology in there and be the first in the market?
It's awesome. It's been a long time coming. You know, if you've been paying attention, you've seen us run teasers on our social media over the years. And it's been a few false starts because we wanted to get this right. We wanted to make sure that the helmet and the technology and the app side were all fully integrated and ready for end consumers without having a hitch. And it's really challenging, right? Because you have people that aren't tech savvy. It needs to be functional for them too. And that's where we went back, and we would take five steps forward, and then we'd take a few steps back and say, okay, we need to make sure this really works. So for me, it's way overdue. Like, I'm like, man, let's go. But I also understand the process that if you're going to launch something this advanced, and for me, this groundbreaking, it has to be right and it has to be perfect. So we're going to still be working through things. It's going to have software upgrades down the line, and that's amazing. It's going to get better and better. But I know going to market with this Formula S helmet, there's absolutely nothing on the market like it.
12K carbon, full, nice, super comfy liner and everything like that. We know everything trickles down. So when can we expect all of this? Is this an instant rollout with every helmet getting this, or is it just Formula S carbon is going to have it right now?
Well, that's a great question, and I truly don't have the answer for that right now, right? It's been such a mission for us to get Formula S to market. We'll see, right? Is the demand just overwhelming that we need to immediately go into integrating it into other products? We'll see. But for us to have all of this available was the most important aspect of all of this, right? And for me, I feel like we're late, right? Most people didn't even know we were working on this, but I feel like we should have been out a long time ago, right? But it needed to be right. And yes, we'll see what consumers give us back. We're going to take feedback. Quin has been so great about, hey, tell us what you want. Tell us the data that you're looking for. We can bring it to you. We can provide firmware upgrades and updates that are going to do that. And I truly don't, you know, I feel like with the age of AI, all these things are happening so fast and technology's evolving. We don't even know what this project's going to look like in 1, 2, 3, 4 years. What we think is so advanced now, we maybe look back and laughing at ourselves in 2023 because we're so far ahead of the game in a couple of years.
So as this helmet comes out now, it's going to be available through WPS dealers everywhere, through Fly Racing, all your online partners and everything like that. So there's going to be a lot of information for people to digest at the local brick and mortar store. What would you say in parting is the most important thing about this? Maybe a misconception that people are going to have, or just like what's the factor that is like the 50-cent sell right now?
Yep, I think to me, there will be lots of upgrades with Ride Analytics. That is going to be a huge part of this. But first and foremost, this is the number one way to find out if you had an impact to your head, right? If you crash and you're not sure how hard you hit, you're not sure if you, maybe you have a concussion, aren't sure, right? There's so many children that crash, parents didn't see it. They don't know if they crashed really hard or they just fell over. This is going to immediately alert you. If you crash, a red light will come on in this sensor right here that'll flash red and tell you that you had a crash. Then you'll be able to go to your app and see exactly how hard your child or you hit. To me, that's enough right there, right? There are so many other elements to this. Your helmet and your phone will call 911 if you're having an emergency or you have a crash. There's so much more, but number one, first and foremost, I believe being able to answer that lifelong question for everybody is, I crashed, how bad was it? Do I need to look into getting a new helmet? That's a really big step right there.